begin with Prime Minister Anthony Albanese, who has just backed the Reserve Bank Governor, as the ABA prepares to make history by handing down a fourth consecutive interest rate hike. The Prime Minister spoke to Today on Nine a short time ago.
He does, and the RBA do have our support. They're an independent authority. Look, we recognise that people are doing it really tough and people are worried about increases in their mortgage. That was foreshadowed well before the federal election that that would occur.
Let's bring in federal politics reporter Fiona Whelan, who's in Canberra. Fee, how much of a rise can we expect to see today?
Well, Charles, the cash rate is expected to rise by another half a percentage point. So that would bring it to the six-year high of 1.85%. And it would mean that a borrower with a $750,000 mortgage would face a monthly increase of more than $200. And if you add up all the rate hikes since May, more than $700 has been added to the repayment of that loan. The RBA governor, Phil Lowe, has faced a lot of criticism for these rate hikes. And today another leading economist has weighed in, Warren Hogan, a former ANZ chief economist and advisor to Federal Treasury, has reportedly accused the Reserve Bank of misleading borrowers. Because last year, Mr. Lowe said it was very likely the cash rate would remain at 0.1% until at least 2024. Now, it wasn't a promise, but many Australians took those words as a sign they could borrow with confidence. Charles?
Fee, thank you. We're going to get to breaking news now. There are live pictures out of Brisbane right now. We'll bring up for you, although you wouldn't be able to tell that that is the River City. No sign of the brown snake. It is just a grey out, that thick blanket of fog covering Brizzy this morning, and it doesn't look like it's clearing anytime soon. There is a road weather alert that has been issued. The Bureau is warning drivers of reduced visibility, as you'd imagine, during the morning commute. The New South Wales government is facing a crisis this morning, with pressure mounting on Deputy Liberal Leader Stuart Ayres to resign. And it all comes back to his involvement in that trade scandal. Here's how that unfolded. In August last year, John Barilaro endorsed the appointment of Jenny West to a New York trade role that he had created. The offer for the $500,000 a year job was then withdrawn in September. The very next month, John Barilaro resigned as Deputy Premier. In December, Stuart Ayres texts John Barilaro the advertisement for that job. And in June, John Barilaro was appointed to the Plum US posting. He stepped down 2 weeks later due to the intense scrutiny. Let's bring in Gabrielle Boyle, who joins us from State Parliament. Gabby, Stuart Ayres is still clinging to his job and says he's done nothing wrong.
He certainly is, Charles. If you're a viewer, you're heading off to work this morning and you're feeling a bit of pressure in the workplace, well, one man that can relate is the New South Wales Premier, because he is also feeling a whole heap of pressure in the top job here in New South Wales at the moment. The pressure is on him to stand down his Trade Minister, Stuart Ayres. Effectively, the suggestion is that he's done the wrong thing by appointing John Barilaro to this very plum position in the US.
I just strongly reject the suggestion that any changes were made to the process to suit John Barilaro. That is just a falsehood.
I tell you what, the New South Wales Treasurer, the New South Wales Trade Minister and, of course, the New South Wales Premier will all have their boxing gloves on. They know that they've got the fight of their life on their hands at the moment, heading into a state election in the coming months. Charles?
Gabby, thank you.
Well, a Brisbane designer received the call of a lifetime when she was asked to dress Beyonce, obviously one of the biggest stars on the planet, for her new album. Bethany Caldwell designed this black and white plastic bodysuit, which features in the singer's new album art collection.
And Bethany joins us now. Bethany, congratulations. I mean, it must be an incredible time for you now, but take us back to that moment when you were contacted and said, hey, the Queen Bee needs a do.
Good morning. It was incredibly exciting. I couldn't believe it when I did receive that email. It was just before Easter, so quite a few months ago now. It was, yeah, just incredibly, incredibly exciting. I didn't believe it at all.
I mean, that outfit is phenomenal. Can you just explain what went into that? So it's made of plastic.
Yeah, so originally it is made from plastic document folders from Officeworks, and I hand cut all the scales and individually sewn all of them onto a bodysuit that I created.
And what's the reaction been like since that dress and that picture came out?
Oh, just incredible. I've had so much support from family and friends and new people who have now found my work through Beyonce wearing my bodysuit. It's just been amazing.
Well, you know that when she does something, everyone follows. So are you ready for the phones to be ringing off the hook?
I think so. I would love that opportunity to keep making custom pieces for celebrities and musicians. I think that's where my style really falls. I think that exciting, shiny and really dramatic silhouettes and textures is meant to be on stage and in front of audiences. So that'd be amazing.
Your local office works is in for a good couple of weeks as well, I imagine.
But congratulations. This is a really, really
they
big
are,
deal.
Yeah.
So celebrate it. Thanks for joining us this morning. I want to introduce you now to Jackson, Jai and Jaden. They are three dirt bike mad brothers from Queensland. They've all got the need for speed.
But this month, they're switching their petrol power for pedal power. They're riding their pushies every day for a month, and they join us along with their parents, Brooke and David, from Helidon Spa, which is just outside of Toowoomba in Queensland. Great to have all five of you on the program this morning. Brooke, this is a big commitment from your boys, but take us through what they're doing it for, because it's a very good cause.
So it's to raise money for the Red Kite charity, which helped us immensely when Jackson was diagnosed last year with cancer. So it's just a way that we can give back, raise some money for a great charity.
So just talk us through what little Jackson there has been through. And I know that you guys, you were living up in the Northern Territory and you've moved now to Helidon Spa to be closer to the hospital. But just how tough has it been and how's he doing?
Last September, we got the news. He had a tumour in his right kidney. We thought it'd be a week trip for Brooke and Jackson down to Brisbane, get the kidney out and he'd be back. And that quickly turned into a six-month stint down in Brisbane. Unfortunately, he couldn't come back to Darwin for any treatment, any checkup. So we're basically split as a family. Me and the two older boys made it down over Christmas, and that's when Red Kite stepped up, helped us enormously with gift vouchers and stuff for Christmas shopping. And then we come down here in May for Jackson's first checkup, which was all good. And that's when we sort of really started to push and make the decision that we needed to be closer to the Queensland Children's Hospital. And yeah, it all happened very quickly, and about 35 days later after settlement, here we are.
He looks like he's doing pretty well there. How's he been through all of this?
I think he probably handled it the best. He just rolled with the punches, not knowing a lot better. The time apart for me and Brooke, and obviously Brooke and the other two boys, that was probably the hardest part. The time apart and, you know, not being there to help Brooke with Jackson and stuff.
Yeah.
But yes, as you can see, he's doing very well. Loving life, hair's growing back, he's on fire.
All right, my question is to Jaden, because Jaden, you're the big brother, mate. How proud are you of your little brother?
Really proud.
It's so nice that you're out there doing this with your brother Jai as well. Jaden, what does it mean to be out there riding your bike every day and sort of giving back? Why did you choose to do that?
Just
to help out.
Yeah.
Give back to the charity.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a good idea.
It's an excuse to ride your bike.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, Jaden, who's the best bike rider out of all of you?
Me.
I thought you might say that.
That's an easy one.
Hey, Brooke, if people want to get involved, how can they do that?
So you can jump on the Red Kite Sun Up Challenge website and you can either create a profile and join in with the challenge, or you can just donate online through the website.
Beautiful. And that website again is sunupchallenge.org.au. So lovely to see you guys this morning.
Yep.
Thanks for coming on. We'll chat to you very, very shortly.
Best of luck with the biking, boys.
Thank you.
See ya.
You.